Finally, 2020 is coming to an end. But is 2021 going to be any better? I think so, but January is going to be a bad month. So let's talk. More people traveled through U.S. airports this past Sunday than any other day this pandemic, about 1.3 million. Now, at the same time, more Americans were hospitalized this past week than any other week of the pandemic. This past week, about 40% of all ICU patients in the U.S. had COVID-19, and that's according to data that was published by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services. That's up from 16% in late September, up from 22% in late October, and 35% in late November. More than 63,000 Americans have already died so far in the month of December, which is the worst month of this entire pandemic. And next month is only going to be worse. Three big reasons. One, because of the holiday travel and indoor gatherings. Two, because of the colder temperatures. And three, that new coronavirus variant, B117, that is more contagious and more transmissible, and it's now here in the United States, as it's just been identified in a Colorado man. So I think that January is going to be the worst month of this entire pandemic. Of course, the way we fight this is with distancing and masks, and the more people that do this, the better the numbers are going to be. And the more people who get the vaccine, the higher the likelihood that we can bring this pandemic to an end. Most experts believe that in order to reach herd immunity, we'll need about 80% of the population to get vaccinated. Most polls show that about 60% of Americans want the vaccine. Based on my YouTube poll, about 10,000 of you voted, and 47% want the vaccine, 37% don't want it, and 16% are still undecided. So this virus is not going to be extinguished anytime soon, especially if these numbers don't change. The soonest I expect this pandemic to be over with would be by next fall, but people need to get vaccinated in order for this to happen. Now, I'm glad that I was able to get my Pfizer vaccine back on December 15th. Other than a little bit of soreness in the first 24 hours or so, I didn't have any side effects. So I feel great, and I'm going to get my second shot about a week from now. Now, with that second shot, the booster shot, the chances of developing side effects are slightly higher compared to the first shot, so we'll see what happens and I'll keep you posted. Now, one concern with these vaccines is the potential for allergic reactions. Reactions to vaccines in general are very rare. The American College of Allergy, Asthma, and Immunology has updated its advice regarding risks of allergic reactions to these new mRNA COVID vaccines. They say that anyone with a severe allergic reaction to the first shot should not get the second shot, and that people with allergies to medications, foods, insects, and latex are no more likely than the general public to be allergic to these vaccines. It's still not clear whether having had an allergic reaction to an older type of vaccine, does that mean that people will react badly to these new mRNA vaccines? Still an unknown at this point. What should be said is that for people who've had previous allergic reactions to a specific component of the new vaccine, such as propylene glycol or lipid nanoparticles, they should hold off on getting the vaccine. Regardless, these people should be discussing the risks and benefits of getting the vaccine with their own healthcare provider, ideally an allergist. So these are the latest recommendations at the time of the making of this video, and of course, they're subject to change. So with the new SARS-CoV-2 mutation, this new variant, scientific experts are saying that it's more contagious, more transmissible. Does that mean that the vaccine will be less effective? This is still an unknown at this point. And if the vaccine is less effective against this new variant, how much so? Again, an unknown. Most scientific experts think that the vaccine will remain effective against it, but only time will tell. Also, if it does mean less effectiveness against this new variant, the good news is that with these mRNA vaccines, they can be easily tweaked and modified in order to accommodate that new strain of the coronavirus. A lot of people are also talking about the parasitic drug ivermectin. Is it useful against COVID? It's too early to tell. There are some weak studies that show it might help against COVID, but there's nothing conclusive so far. We need a large randomized controlled trial to know if it works or not, and that hasn't happened yet. What did just come out, though, from Brazil is a randomized controlled trial for giving vitamin D to patients with severe COVID. we know that low levels of vitamin D are linked with higher risk for having severe COVID. But when vitamin D was given to critically ill COVID-19 patients who had lower vitamin D levels, it did not shorten their length of stay in the hospital or decrease their mortality. Granted, it wasn't the largest study. There was a total of 240 hospitalized patients in this study. So they gave half of those patients vitamin D, and then they gave the other half a placebo. So not the largest study, but it still was significant. But unfortunately, based on the study, there's no benefit of giving vitamin D to critically ill patients who have COVID-19. The way that I look at it, it's important not to be vitamin D deficient in the first place, as getting a large dose of vitamin D when you're critically ill is not going to save you. So I'm gonna end on that note. It's also my last video of 2020. Happy New Year to you, and cheers to 2021.